So we're going to look at the danza of Meyahual. This is the danza dedicated to the essence of the maguey plant. It's a 4x4 danza, meaning that in your plant step, you're going to do a sequence to the left, then to the right, then to the left, and then to the right. Same with your flower steps. The count that I observe with this danza is 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. So that can help you with the mathematics of the danza. This is plant step 1. We'll see the front view and the rear view. At the count of Nali, yay, Nali. Standing diagonally in this position. Yay, now. So the mechanics, you're basically diagonally looking this way, not like this. Not like this, diagonally, right? Carry the weight of your foot, the weight of your body on your right foot, and the left leg is ready for movement. You're gonna tap twice on the ground. As you're stomping on the ground, your right foot should hop off the ground in this manner. Yay, now. Okay, and then you're gonna direct yourself to the left with 3 steps to repeat the mechanics of the step all over again. At the count of Nali, yay, Nali. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, our flower step. Flower one represents death. Why? Because we are directing, walking backwards. We're gonna do that towards the left. If ever you've seen the image of Ehecatl-Quetzalcoatl, and to its back is the image of Mictlantecuhtli, I believe, or Mictlantecuhtli. It's that duality, right, that we represent in our danza, and that is very present in this cultural concept of this tradition. So, for your plant, your base, your flower one, again, you're facing diagonally this way. You're gonna step back. On the third step, you're gonna swing your left foot behind you, and then you're gonna mark two additional steps, alternating the weight of your body in this manner. Yay, now. Human behavior. when we speak, when we see, when we act towards our environment and towards one another, we're leaving an imprint on the planet. So that's representative of our behavior, our footprints, the footprints we leave on Mother Earth. So that is represented by our walking steps when we're dancing. So this flower too represents human behavior, the concept of life moving forward, and the concept of death. At the count of Nawi, we will demo front view and then rear view. Yay, Nawi.
Sometimes having your feet
somewhat apart, and using your arms to center your body helps. Okay, flower five. I will demo the front view, then the rear view, and then the mechanics of the step. At the count of Nawi, yay, Nawi. Texture, colorful smells, we give them as offerings for birth, for love, for thankfulness, appreciation, for parties. So, you're representing Makuisoshi, which is your five extremities, the possibilities of what you can create with your arms, with your hands, what you can create with your legs, with your feet, and what you can create with your fifth extremity, which is your head, the brain that is in here, the neuron connections with all of your nervous system, your body cells, the endless opportunities of creativity. Okay, so the step mechanics are very simple. You stand in this manner, quite centered, right? We're beginning like this. So you're centered, your hands can be this way, right? And you begin jumping, hopping to the left, to the right, and then three hops to the left. And repeat the mechanics in the opposite direction. At the count of Nawi, yay, Nawi. Okay. For our flower six, I will demo front view and then rear view. So at the count of Nawi, yay, Nawi. So now we will do the rear view. Yay, Nawi. So the mechanics for flower six, you're standing diagonally facing forward, right, in the diagonal position, carrying the weight of your body on your right foot. The left is ready to go. So, yay, Nawi. Kick, 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 and squat. Kick, kick, one, two, squat. Kick, kick, one, two, squat. Kick, kick, one, two, squat. So for the final flower, flower seven, we're representing wind, communication again, and squat, respect. In this manner, I will demo front view, then rear view, and then mechanics. Yay, Nawi. Now we're gonna demo our rear view. So position yourself in a way that you're ready to turn, right? You can use your arms to push off the weight of your body. At the top of Nawi. Yay? Nawi. So the mechanics for our last flower, flower seven, are the expression of thankfulness and appreciation with our feet. And that is done, right? When we kick our feet in that manner in a Danza circle, we're saying thank you. We're creating joyful sound, right? A happy, joyful sound. So little kicks like that, you're representing thankfulness and appreciation. And then again, when you're turning, it's about wind, communication, sound waves that travel, right, in space. So for this one again, be sure that you do your 360 degree turn on two steps. So you will do one, two, right? Let's do it again. I'll give you the rear two. So one, two, kick, kick, and squat. Again, right? Sometimes when you do it slow, it's a little bit more challenging. So again, yay, now we step, step, kick, kick, squat, step, step, kick, kick, squat. Regular pace would be like this. With the drum, yay, now we. Danza of Meyahual, at least one of the versions that we know here in Chicago. When you prepare yourself for Danza, it's important to warm up before you begin to the practice of Danza. It can be quite challenging and straining for your muscles, so you want them to be nice and warm so that they don't get injured, torn or pulled in a way that it's going to inconvenience or harm you. Also, be sure to warm down at the end of your danza. And as you're offering the danza, have an intention for why you're dancing. Again, this is an opportunity for you to connect with nature, with everything that surrounds you, an opportunity for you to release negative or positive energy in a beautiful, balanced way. It's an opportunity to sweat, release some toxins, build some condition for your body, have your heart, you know, activated, your blood circulating. So always be thankful for your body, for every cell of your body, all of your systems, right, that they allow you this opportunity to engage in Danza and to meditate through it and to have a beautiful expression. So thank you. I hope that this was a helpful video for everyone. And it's especially dedicated to Angelina because she was insisting and persevering on her request for this video. Senka plaza kamat. Hometeo.